everyone. Welcome to day 3 of Concrete and Cranes. Great to see you again. My name is Miss Kristen.
And my name's Miss Jenny. Hello.
Jenny, are you ready to welcome our friends here today?
Yes.
Let's give a big builder's welcome to
Eliana, Lincoln, and Jonah.
Welcome, friends.
And welcome to all our friends today here at the worksite. Jenny, why are you wearing that silly hat?
Because we're going to play a game. One of us will put on a hat, and someone will call out who wears that kind of hat. So if I put on a hard hat, someone would call out, construction worker. Okay, you ready to play?
Yes.
Who wears this kind of hat? That's right, someone at a party.
Who wears this? You're right, a baseball player.
And who wears this hat? Right, a cowboy or a cowgirl.
And who wears this hat? A chef wears this kind of hat.
You all really know your hats.
And you also know how great it is to be here, building together on the love of Jesus.
Sometimes life can be a hard hat zone, but even in our toughest times, Jesus loves us no matter what.
Jesus loves us with a great love. That reminds me of John 15:13 that says, no one has a greater love than this, than to lay down his life for his friends.
That's great love. I'm looking forward to learning more about that great love. So I guess we better put on our hard hats before we get to work.
And let's put on our thinking caps too, because we will have a lot of good things to think about today.
I don't think I brought a thinking cap. What is that?
Jenny, a thinking cap isn't real. It's just something people say. It means that you get ready to think. So are you ready? Are you ready to laugh, think, play, learn, and sing?
I am.
I am too. Are you ready? Let's get started.
Hi everyone. Welcome to High Steel Worship Rally. Do you remember what we learned about yesterday? Yes, we learned that Jesus is the foundation of forgiveness. So let's start our rally by singing the song we learned yesterday about forgiveness. Now, let's review our VBS motto. Do you remember our VBS motto? Our motto is, Jesus is our strong foundation. Say it with me. Jesus is our strong foundation. Let's say it one more time together. Can you make strong arms while you say it with me? Jesus is our strong foundation. Yesterday, we learned that Jesus is the foundation of forgiveness. That means that Jesus loves us even though you're a sinner. Now, let's watch another video about Renzo and Lloyd. Do you remember what happened yesterday? Renzo and Lloyd sure made a mess of things. Let's find out what they do today.
It was not such a good start for the young builder. Renzo had smarts, but that's not the same as having wisdom. He had a lot to discover about building things.
Renzo, our competition is doing it faster. Cobra Comb Construction has finished the foundation.
What? How is that possible? We started at the same time.
I didn't know cobras use combs.
I think it's metaphoric.
He's how they're beating us.
Yeehaw! In the dust, Renzo, right?
That's Foreman Niemeyer, the most ruthless and underhanded contractor in the business. If he's involved, we better watch our back.
Hey, Renzo! See this load of girders? That means tomorrow we start building up to the sky. What do you have? Oh, you got a hole in the ground. Tough luck, Renzo. A hole in the ground.
Holes are just upside down mountains.
Hey, guess what? It's quitting time, boys.
Come on, Lloyd.
Ooh, what are we doing?
Getting to the truth. Lloyd, don't make a sound. Starting now.
I shall call him Growly.
Lloyd!
Growly, why?
Take that!
Oh, should I give him a turnip bone?
Lloyd, what are you doing?
Oh! I think I'm moving it with my mind.
Lloyd, it's Foreman Niemeyer!
I hope you're not afraid of heights, Renzo. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. And now he's up a tree.
I've never been this high up. I'm scared.
Don't worry, Renzo. I'll save us. Hi, Renzo.
I'm not feeling safe, Lloyd.
She'll call you Growly Jr.
That's the last straw, kid.
Before you yell, more, let me just say I know how Foreman Niemeyer is beating us.
Go on.
It's easy to build fast when you skip the most important part. Most houses we live in are built on the ground. Pour a little concrete, let it settle a while, and that's okay for a house. But this is a skyscraper. They skipped building a strong foundation.
The higher you build a skyscraper, the stronger the foundation must be. Workers must blast into the solid rock found deep beneath the soil. This supports the entire building and keeps it standing, whatever storm may come.
Mr. Santiago, I'm sorry for being such a goofus.
You're forgiven, kid. So, we gonna build a strong foundation, or what?
You bet!
Just like a skyscraper's foundation is essential, so are the foundations you are building in your life. Foundations of love and family, and the most important, the foundation in our Heavenly Father. When we follow Jesus, we are digging a deep foundation to prepare us for the good days and the hard ones.
Okay, we have a solid foundation. Now, we head for the clouds.
Today, Renzo and Lloyd were determined to find out how Cobra was building their building so fast. It seems they missed out on the most important part, the foundation. Just like Renzo's parents and Santiago prayed for Renzo, Jesus prayed for us, and we're gonna learn more about that today in our Blueprint Bible study. Now, let's get ready to learn our new song. Let's stand up and get ready to dance. Here we go.
This is the song, Blueprint. Now you're going to start the song off by kicking your heel two times. So one, two, three, four. Do it again. One, two, three, four. One more time. One, two, three, four. And then you're gonna bring your hands to your knees and you're gonna count here for a four count. Now you're gonna start off with God made a way. So you're gonna bring your hands to your shoulders and lean back. God made a way. And then push up with your hands together. And then you're gonna bring your hand around for you to know him. Bring your hand back around. He came to save you. And with your hands together, you're gonna push down from your sin. What you need to know is. Now we're gonna jump into the ABCs. So A, admit to God that you're a sinner and repent. B, believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And then with your hands together, C, confess your faith in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. Big windmill. Now you're gonna start into the chorus. Here is the blueprint, God's plan. Build, hammer both your fists down. Build your life on the great I am. Then both hands down together. Jesus is everything we need. Now you're gonna do the blueprint one more time. Here is the blueprint. You'll find you are part of a grand design. Then bring your hands down again. Jesus is everything you need. Now you're gonna start into the second verse. God made a way, just like the first verse, for you to know him. He came to save you from your sins. What you need to know is. Then you're gonna go back into the ABCs. Let's do it again. A, admit to God that you're a sinner and repent. B, believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And then C, confess your faith in Jesus as Savior and Lord. So now you're going to jump back into the chorus. Here is the blueprint, God's plan. Build your life on the great I am. Jesus is everything you need. Do the blueprint again. Here is the blueprint. You'll find you are part of a grand design. Jesus is everything you need. Now you're gonna go right into the bridge. No one has greater love than this to lay down his life for a friend. No one has greater love than this. And you're gonna bring your hands into a circle. Whoa-oh. Do it again. No one has greater love than this to lay down a life for his friend. No one has greater love than this. Oh, wah-ha-ha-oh. Now you're gonna do the blueprint chorus one more time. Here is the blueprint, God's plan. Build your life on the great I am. Jesus is everything you need. Blueprint one more time. Here is the blueprint, you'll find you are part of a grand design. Jesus is everything you need. Then do Jesus is everything you need. One more time. Jesus thus, is everything you need. Now from here, you're gonna go to your shoulder and then end with your arms up. And now you know the song, Blueprint.
Great job, everyone. You'll get a chance to sing and dance to this song again later on. Go ahead and sit down. Well, it sure was fun doing our High Steel Worship Rally together. Now you get to go learn more about Jesus in Blueprint Bible Study. Let's go.
Hi, kids. Welcome to day 3 of the Blueprint Bible Study. Wow, this week is going fast. In today's episode of Steel Town, Santiago discovered that it was the crooked contractor foreman Niemeyer, who is trying to outdo them by building a skyscraper that was bigger and taller than Renzo's design. Renzo and Lloyd snuck over in the middle of the night to figure out Niemeyer's secret of his success, only to find out that the crooked contractor did not build a strong foundation for his skyscraper. After a harrowing adventure, Renzo and Lloyd ended up back with Santiago and not without spilling his coffee again. Santiago graciously forgave Renzo for being a goofus, and Renzo promised to build a firm foundation for the skyscraper. It's important for us to build a firm foundation, too. Let's find out more about this in today's Blueprint Bible Study. Yesterday, we learned about the Apostle Paul and how God chose him to preach the good news of forgiveness that Jesus offers to the Gentiles, or those who were not Jewish. Paul was able to tell King Agrippa about his own story of forgiveness. Do you remember? When Paul was a Pharisee and strictly followed the Jewish laws and rules, he spoke out openly against Jesus and placed many of Jesus' followers in jail. He even supported the ruler's decision to put Jesus to death. Paul's story is a great example of how Jesus can change any heart and forgive our biggest sins. Today, we are going to hear about a hard night that Jesus had in the Garden of Gethsemane as he prepared his mind and heart to make the ultimate sacrifice for you and for me. Let's read about it in Matthew chapter 26. Jesus knew he had come to earth to be the savior of the world. He knew that meant he would have to die. On the last night Jesus spent with his disciples, he took them to a place called Gethsemane. Jesus said to the men, "Sit here while I go and pray." Then Jesus asked Peter and two other disciples, James and John, to go a little farther with him. Jesus was very sad and troubled because he knew he was going to die on the cross to save people from their sins. Jesus asked Peter, James, and John to stay awake with him because he was so distressed. When Jesus had gone a little farther into the garden alone, he fell to his knees and he began to pray. He asked God if there was any other way to provide forgiveness other than by dying. Jesus did not want to disobey his Father, but he also knew all things are possible with God. Jesus told God that he would do whatever God wanted him to do. And Jesus returned to Peter, James, and John, but found them sleeping. He said to Peter, "Couldn't you stay awake with me for just an hour? Stay awake and pray." Jesus went alone a second time to pray. When he came back, the three were asleep again because they could not keep their eyes open. Finally, Jesus went alone a third time to pray. When he returned, he found the three men sleeping. He told them to get up and go with him. Jesus knew it was time to go with the soldiers and follow through with God's plan. He was willing to suffer and die on the cross to save us from our sin. Greater love has no one than someone lay down his life for his friends. John chapter 15, verse 13. Jesus did exactly what this verse says. He laid down his life when he died on the cross. He did that because he loves you. He took the punishment for your sin and the sins of the whole world. So let's see how the memory verse is coming. Let's practice together. Say it with me. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians chapter 1, verse 6. Jesus prayed in the garden to confess to God his fears about what was to come. But he knew the path that God chose for him and that he would need to complete his work and sacrifice here on earth in order to fulfill God's plan. Why did Jesus go to the garden? That's right, to pray. What did Peter, James, and John do while Jesus prayed? You are right, they fell asleep. This hurt Jesus because he wanted them to be with him and pray with him. True or false? Jesus chose to die for me. This is absolutely true. We can always find joy in knowing that we have a Savior who was willing to die for us. When Jesus was nailed to the cross, he experienced a punishment for our sins so we would never have to experience it ourselves. Say this with me, kids. Jesus chose to die for me. If you are interested in trusting Jesus as your Savior, please ask your parents to talk and pray with you to ask Jesus into your heart. We hope you enjoyed day 3 of our Blueprint Bible study, learning about Jesus' prayer in the Garden of Gethsemane. Now let's go back to High Steel and check in with Miss Kristen and Miss Jenny. See you back here tomorrow for day 4.
I see you're wearing your hard hat now, Jenny.
And you are wearing yours too.
Yeah, those other hats didn't fit very well. I'm going to stick with my hard hat.
I am too. And my thinking cap.
Now I'm going to have to think about that.
What do you think about what we learned today? That Jesus chose to die for you and for me and for all of us.
Jesus chose to die for me, and that reminds me of the foundation of worth we built on today. Jesus said we are worthy of God's love.
And we should see others the same way. Not just our friends, but everyone.
Do you still have your thinking cap on, Jenny?
Yep.
I keep it under my hard hat. Remember that song we learned earlier today, Blueprint? Want to sing it together?
Yes, let's sing it all together.
Did a fantastic job working today. We can't wait to see you tomorrow.
Bye.